Before learning the exercise problems, we need to remember few points. One is CPCT. What is CPCT? Corresponding. C means corresponding parts. P means parts of congruent triangles are equal. CPCT means corresponding parts of congruent triangles. So the corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. So if you observe in these two triangles, as per SAS congruency, these two are congruent to each other. Already we have seen in the previous video. That is, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF by SAS congruency. SAS means here three parts are equal. What about the remaining parts? The remaining three parts are also equal. As per in corresponding parts of congruent triangles rule, the remaining three parts are also equal. If you observe in these both the triangles, AC is corresponding part of DF. AC is equal to DF. And also the other two angles, this angle, angle A is equal to angle D. Next one is angle C is equal to angle F. So like that, in any two congruent triangles, the remaining corresponding parts are also equal. We will be using this concept even in solving the exercise problems. So the other point that you need to remember is, already you have learned four congruent criteria. Now if you observe these two set of triangles, triangle PQR and triangle XYZ, both are congruent to each other as per ASA congruency. ASA congruency, they are congruent to each other. So here two angles and the included side of triangle PQR equal to two angles and the included side of triangle XYZ are equal. So as per ASA congruency, both are congruent to each other. Triangle PQR is congruent to triangle XYZ. Okay, so one more point, let us see children. What is the angle sum property of triangle? Sum of three angles, three interior angles of triangle is 180 degrees. So two angles are 60 and 45, which is 105 degrees. What is the third angle? Third angle is 180 minus sum of these two, which is 75 degrees. And here also the same 75 degrees you will get. That means, what did you observe? If two angles are equal in a triangle, definitely the third angle is going to be equal as per angle sum property. So once we'll take same measurements here, but in this case we'll take angle P as 75 degrees and also angle X as 75 degrees. Now if you observe these two set of triangles, triangle PQR and triangle XYZ, if you observe these two angles, angle and side. But here, what is the difference between these two? The side is not included in between two angles. The side is not included between these two angles. That is the difference between both the set of angles. So now also, is it the angle R is going to be equal to 45 or not? Once check. What is again angles, as per angle sum property, what is the sum of these two angles? 60 plus 75, 135 degrees. The third angle is 45 degrees. Even this case also will be getting 45 degrees. So, if the angles are given in any which way in the given triangle and one side, two angles and one side are given, also they will become congruent triangles. So, then you can write it as the congruency. Here you have written as a ASA congruency. In this case, you will be writing triangle PQR is congruent to triangle XYZ by AAS congruency. Here, in this case, side is not in between these two angles. That is the difference. So, you can also apply AAS congruency rule in solving the exercise problems. These two points you need to remember. So, the first question given was, in quadrilateral ACBD, given that AC equal to AD, AC equal to AD, and AB bisects angle A. AB line segment bisects angle A. That means angle A is divided into two equal parts. So, this is equal to this one. So, how will you name these two angles once, see children? These two angles you can name in two different ways. One is starting from B, angle B, A, C you can name it, or else angle C, A, B you can name it. But name them with the corresponding parts exactly. Okay. So, if I name it like C, A, B angle and B, A, D angle, it is not correct. So, for the angle C, the corresponding part is D. From there you need to start naming the angle. So, angle CAB will be equal to angle DAB. So, that information we have. Automatically, these two will be equal. That means, here one angle also we have equal. Two parts are equal. So, we need to recognize only one part, third part. So, it may be SAS congruency. SAS congruency or SAA congruency. Let us recognize one angle or one side which is equal in both the triangles. If you observe the two triangles, AB is common side to both the triangles. Anyway, the common side will be equal to each other. So, now they asked us to prove triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ABD. So, triangle ABC, triangle ABD. So, related to these equal parts, you can write it. So, first one given is AC equal to AD, which is side. Next one, already we know that angle CAB is equal to angle DAB, which is angle. One more is, we observe that this is common side for these two triangles, triangle ABC and triangle ABD. AB is common side. So, we will write AB is equal to AB. We need to write the reason also why we have taken like that, common side. So, we got SAS congruency. Therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ABD by SAS congruency rule. They asked one more question also related to this sum. What do you say about BC and BD? What do you say about BC and BD? BC and BD. What is the relation between BC and BD? What do you say? So, if two triangles are congruent, we just now learnt that the remaining corresponding parts are also equal. Therefore, what do you say? Therefore, BC is equal to BD by CP CD. In quadrilateral ABCD, given AD equal to BC. AD is equal to BC. Next one is given angle DAB equal to angle CBA. angle DB, DAB equal to angle CBA. So these two angles are equal. So in the given data, we have two equal parts. Then, what is required to prove? RTP means required to prove. Triangle ABD is congruent to triangle BAC. ABD, so we do not have any triangles here. Let us join them to get the triangles. Join the diagonals. Now we got the two triangles, triangle ABD and triangle BAC. So these two triangles we need to prove them as congruent triangles. So first one, triangle ABD and triangle BAC. If you take, so in triangle ABD we have AD is equal to the other triangle BAC, we have BC equal. So, side AD is equal to BC. Next one, angle DAB is equal to angle CBA. This is also given in the sum, which is angle. Next, third part we need to recognize. If you observe carefully, for the both the triangles, AB is common side. Common side. So we can write it as a AB. So for A, corresponding part is B. So we need to write in that manner, BA is equal to side again. So SAS congruency, by SAS congruency, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle BAC. BD equal to AC. Observe the sides BD and AC. They are the other corresponding parts of both the triangles ABD and BAC. As per corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal, we can write that BD is equal to AC by CP, CD. Next, third one they asked is angle ABD. Angle ABD is equal to angle BAC. ABD equal to BAC, BAC. They are also corresponding angles. So, angle ABD is equal to angle BAC, again by CP, CD. Hence, wrote. So here it is given that AD is equal to BC. AD is equal to BC. And AD is also perpendicular to BC. So angle DAO is equal to 90 degrees. And also angle CBO is equal to 90 degrees. And third equal measurement we need to find out. So if you observe this diagram, here CD and AP are intersecting each other. So, when two lines are intersecting each other, they will be formed vertically opposite angles. So, this angle is equal to this angle. That is, angle DOA is equal to angle COB. Both are vertically opposite angles. So, we have now in each triangle three equal parts, two angles and side. So, already we discussed that if two angles and side are equal also, they will be congruent to each other. So, let us write the proof. So, triangle DOA and triangle, the corresponding part to D is C. COB. Now, you can write the corresponding parts. In these two triangles, already given that AD is equal to BC, this is given side. The other part is given 90 degrees. That is, angle A is equal to angle B is equal to 90 degrees. So, this is angle.
So other part just now we have found that angle DOA is equal to angle COB. Since they are vertically opposite angles, therefore triangle DOA is congruent to triangle COB by AAS congruency. They asked us to prove CD bisects AB. CD bisects AB. That means if CD is bisecting AB, BO must be equal to AO. And if you observe AO and BO, they are corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Therefore, AO is equal to BO by CP CD. Therefore, we can write as CD bisects AB. Hence, proved. Given that L and M are parallel lines which are intersected by another two parallel lines P and Q. So, parallel lines, all of you know how to show with the symbol. So, L is parallel to M and also P is parallel to Q. So, the figure formed ABCD quadrilateral, if you observe, in this ABCD quadrilateral, both the pairs of opposite sides are parallel. So, it is a parallelogram. A quadrilateral in which both the pairs of opposite sides are parallel is a parallelogram. Therefore, ABCD is a parallelogram. And all of you know that the parallelogram's properties. The properties of parallelograms are opposite sides are parallel and equal. So, here AD is equal to BC and also AB is equal to DC. Then, as per the given sum, they asked us to prove triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CDA. To get these two triangles, we need to draw the diagonal by joining A and C. Now you can get the triangles, triangle ABC and triangle CDA. So now, let us find out the equal parts. Triangle ABC, triangle CDA. So, in these two triangles, AB is equal to given. AB is equal to opposite sides are equal. So, AB is equal to CD. Side. Then, BC is equal to DA. This is also side. Third equal part we need to recognize. That is nothing but AC. AC is common side for both the triangles. Therefore, AC is equal to CA, which is common side. So, triple S congruency we can observe. And therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CDA by SSS congruency.